Oh, it's working. There we go. Good evening, everybody. Good evening. This is really late night. This is 11:45 p.m. Normally the commander's on at 11, but it is late night and you all are beautiful people. You actually waited for the commander to get on late night. This is the late night show, really. 11:45 p.m. East Coast with Commander Alion, your hostess of the mostest for the man from planet Mars, with the Ashtar Galactic Command, talk show host of WESU-FM's NPR Pacifica radio show, Ash Command Radio, for over 21 years. Here to bust the Matrix, and we are busting the Matrix. Contactee from the 60s, motivator, and here to do what we need to do. Hey, Alicia. It was wonderful if you were on the ship. No, I was watching, believe it or not, the commander was watching a UConn basketball game that ended only a while ago. UConn basketball, you know, I like to watch basketball every once in a while, and they did good. Hey, Flower Power, good to see you. Peace, love, and light, good to see you. Good to see everybody coming in here from all over the world. Avario, for all our relatives. Paul, welcome to the show. User 815. We got everybody coming in here from all over the planet Earth to the number one spiritual UFO talk show on social media. Hey, Ashley, good to see you. Adrian, good to see you. We got all past the Monday. Hey, none of your business. The Dude, welcome to the show. King, Kirby, Kit Kat, hey, sister, how you doing? Truly, Cavote, Sierra, welcome to the show. Gypsy, welcome to Encounters. This is where we are, a show that's really out of this world, you know. A show that's totally out of this world. Hey, good to see you. Hi, my cup of tea. Cecilia, or Celia, twin, good to have you with us. Leslie, welcome. Bount Farrell, welcome to the show. We're on this morning. All our shows are caught up. Our morning show is on our YouTube channel. All our shows are on our YouTube channel. So if you've missed any of our shows, morning or night, Ashtar Command Spaceship News is our YouTube channel. You can watch all our shows, the ones from this morning, and also from last night. So you're not going to miss a thing. This show is also being recorded. And if anybody misses any parts of this show, you can see it on YouTube later on. Good to have everybody here. As I said about the eclipse, nothing happened. All these people going all over the world with their extreme views about the eclipse. And the commander kept it real. Nothing happened. Well, there was an eclipse that happened. And maybe some spiritual awakenings, but nothing else really happened, you know. Good to have you all with us. Hey, Anna, welcome to the show. Dr. Alan Pops, biologist, welcome. Rebel 6724, Earthly Angel. Catalina, good to have you with us. Ashley, thanks for coming back in. Bobby Phillips, all the people coming. I have no idea what's going to happen tonight. Hey, Jesse, the one thing I love about my show since I started it, it's spontaneous, and you never know who's going to show up. And there's always somebody with a great story to tell. Always somebody with a great story to tell. So the way that works is for people that want to tell their space stories about their encounters with space people, sightings that they're having with spaceships, you know, Bigfoot, it could be mermaids, it could be fairies. This is the place where all those stories come true. This is where it happens, where people come out of the closet and tell what's happening. Hey, good to see you, April. Good to see you, Jan. Robert, I seen something strange today. Robert, today, what did you see that was strange? What was strange that you were seeing today? I'm very curious. If you can tell me in a sentence what you were seeing that was strange today, I'm very interested what the strange thing was. Kimmy BOP, welcome. Clover, welcome to the show. If you're not here on the show, folks, then I don't know where you are. Hey, Cheryl Lee, welcome. Lavola, welcome. And of course, we have our apple cider. Excuse me. We have lots of apple cider. We have a whole glass of the commander's apple cider. That's the space drink of the commander. I'm wondering if my parents on the ship would drink apple cider. I'm wondering if I can bring a jug of apple cider on the spaceship when we go. Robert Jackson, a snake or dragon-like figure. That's kind of weird. That's kind of weird. Z says no. No, Z. I can't bring apple cider on the spaceship. I think they'll probably say yes. Government owns apple cider. Government owns apple cider? Not where I go. I get my apple cider at an apple orchard. And I know the people that make the apple cider. And it's good. But no, this apple cider that I get is not, this is off-season apple cider. But on season, I get good apple cider. Great. Hey, Healing Energy, good to see you. And welcome to the show. Apple cider is good. Yes, it is good. And I will always drink apple cider. I go to the local apple orchards during the season. Did you get the video? I don't think I saw the video. April, I don't think I saw the video. I was looking this afternoon at work. I'm not sure what time you sent it, but if you send it again, I probably will get it. And then I've been in and out of the messages. And yeah, so send it to me again. I'll take a look. Seen a UFO. Twin says, I've seen a UFO. Where'd you see the UFO, Twin, and when did you see it? I saw two UFO videos. I have two UFO videos recorded during the ellipse and comets. Hey, Dimples, good to see you. Give them my Addy. It was moving very fast, Robert Jackson says. How long does apple cider stay fresh? Well, the local orchards said sell apple cider, have a refrigeration system that it stays fresh pretty much throughout the season, that they can sell it on after the season at the apple orchards I go to. But the good stuff is usually, hey, Johnny, good to see you. Apple cider towards probably September, October is when you start getting it. Hey, Frequency 51. Houston, Arizona, was very weird outside today. The air felt charged. Yeah, we had, speaking of the eclipse, I saw a whole bunch of people going out to look at it from where I was. But then it got overcast, and they saw it for a few minutes, and then it was overcast. Mindy, welcome to the show. Oh, I overheard a woman with a heavy country accent say not to worry about the celery eclipse. The celery eclipse. B Kitchens, welcome. John Z, welcome to our show. This is Encounters for new people that are coming here. This is an actual talk show, believe it or not, on TikTok. And I am your host, Commander Alion from Mars, also with the Ashtar Galactic Command. Hey, Pearl, good to have you with us. If you watch this show long enough, you'll be addicted. I guarantee you, hey, Lacey, you'll be, if you watch this show long enough, I guarantee you it'll be a great addiction. It'll be an addiction you can't get away from. Guaranteed. Hey, Penn, welcome to the show. Did you say you are from Mars? Yes. Gina is blessed. Yes, I am from Mars. I came here in birth as a starseed. I work with the Ashtar Galactic Command, but I originally came from Mars, a planet with 10 to 15 million spiritual human beings of light that live on the planet. Yes. Yes, so I do come from Mars. Hey, Jim, thank you for the roses. I came out of the closet about being from Mars a number of years ago, and I love the planet Mars, and I love the universe, and I love being here doing the mission work. There's a number of people on this planet from Mars. Not all of them have come out saying they're from Mars, but I have a long time ago come out of the closet on that. Hey, Rabbi, good to see you. Good to see everybody coming in here. And truly, this is late night. I mean, I got on about 11:43 p.m. So we're just getting started. getting the ball rolling here on the show. Good to have everybody with us. And we're really excited. It's going to be Tuesday morning pretty soon. Jake, I just got home from watching the eclipse. In totality, it was quite the moving experience. Beautiful. I know a lot of people were watching it. Some people weren't. And it's all good, whatever you decide to do. Watch it, not watch it. All right. Hey, Linda, good to see you. And to be a guest on the show, one of the commander's requirements is very simple. You have to be over 18, no kids on the show, no drinking, no drunks, no drugs, and simply no smoking. And the word no smoking means no smoking on the show whatsoever. If any of those things are more important to you, then obviously you don't need to be interviewed. Excuse me. The other thing is no foul language whatsoever. I mean, if something slips in a contact conversation, that happens. Excuse me. And finally, the other thing is no paranormal discussion. So if you've had ET encounters and UFOs and you say, I've had some paranormal stuff happen, leave the paranormal stuff out of the show. No paranormal. There's other people out there on TikTok that are really into that. We're strictly into the cosmic galactic levels of conversation. That's it. So you know, at least now you know the format of the program, okay? So yeah. Now that we've had this eclipse, for me, I feel it's a transformational energy. You know, I didn't really have to go out there and look at the eclipse. I just think that depending who you are, it could be affecting you different ways spiritually, but I think it is a turning point. I think it's a turning point for us, a transformational energy that we're going through. And I think it affects everybody differently too. And I think everybody, whatever the effects are that you had on it, I think it is a spiritual experience. Yes, Jake. What's forced upon you? Nothing's forced upon anybody. Forced upon who? Charlotte, me too, you know. Everybody has their own projections of their own reality, which is kind of cool. Oh, the eclipse? Oh, it's not forced on anybody. It just happens. You can either look at it or not look at it. You can either go skiing or swimming. Jason says, I had some crazy vivid dreams. Hey, Sandra. I think it's Sandra. Hello. Let's see. Lisa says, I had symptoms yesterday, but not today. Headaches yesterday. Let's see here. I'm just reading people's comments here. It was extremely beautiful. Excuse me. Hey, Alan. Good to see you. I don't know why I'm coughing here. I don't have a cold. Thank you, Heart Me. Welcome to see you. Hey, Carlin Mahanahan. Good to see you. Callie, Go-Go, Russ Weatherford, Raiders 895. Carlin, good to see you. Yee Boli Wally P. Who? Sil, good to see you. Hey, Jay, good to have you with us. It was great having you on the other night. From good old Australia. I can't do an impression of Australia too good, but... Hey, 699, welcome, Nancy. Welcome to the show. Rita, everybody around the world. Like I said, we started late tonight. We were watching UConn basketball. One of the few things I do watch on TV. And they did very well tonight. So it was kind of fun watching a basketball game. You know? Amber and the mom, thanks for the likes. So we hopefully will get some new people in here to interview. And we're certainly feeling really good. And we're going to get into Tuesday now. We're only days away from our event. So we're really excited about that. And, we're just going to... Now, for those people that are in the Connecticut area, the light workers, the people that are centered, and I want to make sure people are centered. I'm going to be very careful about this. That are coming to our... Ashtar Command contact program project here in Connecticut on the 13th. You need to email me. And if you email me or message me, I'll give you information more about it. I need to know something about you, who's coming. I might know you just from having you on our show, or you've just been with me like for as much as I've been on here for on TikTok. And again, we have some beautiful things that are going to happen. Communion with Christopher Walker is the best Encounters movie. I think the best movie I've ever watched is Cocoon, the series of movies with Cocoon that was really beautiful about the light beings. That was a beautiful movie. Contact with Jodie Foster was a beautiful movie. Spaceman, which is another beautiful movie. Did I? You know what? April, I forgot to put my goals up here. I do have a goal. Thank you, April, for reminding me. I have a goal. My goal is to, because I like baseball caps, tonight's goal, we're starting with baseball caps. So we appreciate all the support. I'm just moving the lighting here. All the support from everybody, all the brothers and sisters out there. And yeah, so for me, I love baseball caps. So that helps support the work I'm doing here on most nights that I'm here. Yeah, that's right. Yes, and I'm being careful that I don't say that word right now, April. You know what'll happen if that happens. April knows what'll happen if I say that word. but we have so many beautiful things happening on the planet. You know, there's so many things that most people on this world don't even know about that we've shared with you. So my guests have all shared their different experiences. Some have been abductees. Some have had beautiful, recently, a lot of contactees, a lot of people having beautiful contacts all over the world, you know, and we're having them on the show. People are coming forward and these are real people with real experiences. So you can't beat that. Friends, Lindsay, good to see you. And I think I love the fact that people are able to come out of the closet here on my show and share their experiences. That's the benefit of disclosure. Disclosure is not coming from any one government. It's not coming at all from the government. As a matter of fact, the governments aren't doing anything. You know, they're playing little games with the public about disclosure. So they throw through videos out and say the Air Force, videotaped TikToks in the sky flying. They call them TikToks now. They were UFOs originally, but now the UFOs are TikToks. You know, next thing you know, they're going to call them Tic Tacs, or they'll come up with another name 2 years later. The truth is, does anybody truly believe that any world government agency is coming forward with the truth? Really? You know? None of them are. None of them are. I've told this to people ever since I've been on here. You know, then they'll be calling UFOs TikTok. So TikTok will become a UFO now. So they'll say, oh, let's change the name to TikTok for the UFOs. TikTok's not good enough, but TikTok has a rhyme to it. But then TikTok would go after the Pentagon for calling them TikTok. That's right. The government will never be truthful with the people. You know, it's the truth. It's the way it is. But you can be guaranteed on here, the commander is busting the matrix. On this show, that's why it's number one, because we are out here saying the truth, cosmic truth, and nothing but the truth, and it'll set you free if you watch my show. Guaranteed. Hey, young Skywalker, good to see you. Excuse me. So not only that, the commander busts the matrix on every single level on Earth society. I don't care if you're a religious person. I don't care if you're a scientist. I don't care if you're, you know, somebody in government. I don't care. I'm fired up. The commander doesn't care. You know why? Because all that stuff is part of the control mechanism of the planet. I don't care if you're a bigwig on a TV station out there watching this. I don't care. You're not telling the people the truth. Your networks aren't telling people the truth about the existence of our brothers and sisters from other planetary systems. You know, the government says it doesn't believe it unless I am actually living in which it hasn't happened. Excuse me. Man, what is it tonight? Good thing for the apple cider. So as we progress forward, folks, I don't know why the lighting is so kind of weird tonight, but it is. That's better there. Let's see. Can I do this here? No, that's working better. It just seems, apparently, that... Can I bring this up just a little bit? I'm just playing with the lighting here, trying to figure out where the best lighting is. I think I have it kind of figured out here. Oh, that's good. That'll work for me. There we go. No news, do not tell truth heavily manipulated. We have had so much news manipulated and minimized. Yeah, and if you notice, all the news channels, at least in the United States, show the same news every single day on Earth-based TV. The news is always the same. You don't hear anything about UFOs, about anything like that. And when they do show a story, unless it's sanctioned by the government to be allowed to be showed, the media doesn't tell you anything about UFOs or, anything like that. They just don't do it. They have all the fluff news, and they have the same news about the war here every single morning, or about the politicians in your countries. Never about the more important things, which is that we have a planet being visited by space people, right? They don't talk about that. Oh, they can't talk about that, because then that would shake everybody up, you see? If you told people a little ounce of cosmic truth, what would that do, right? So let's be cosmically truthful. There's not one government wherever you live, no media wherever you live, that will ever tell you the truth. We have investigative reporters and we're doing a special on UFOs tonight on the BBC. And we're going to tell you something about the Ministry of Defense in England. We have documents that have been released telling us more information about the UFOs and what the Ministry of Defense actually did. And in fact, they never tell you anything. And when they release information to the public, be it the Pentagon or the Ministry of Defense or the Chinese news agency or whatever, they only tell you what they want to tell you, right? They only show you what they want to show you, right? That's what they do. Commander knows that. I've been around the block here a few times. I met all kinds of people. Even somebody who was formerly with the British government many years ago at a UFO conference. And this chap told me he had connections in the CIA. And when he contacted the people in the CIA that he knew, they said they could not come forward because they would lose their pension, which is the truth. If anyone in the CIA came forward within the CIA regarding extraterrestrial UFOs, they would be out of a pension. So they were afraid to come forward. That's when I was doing my TV show. I met this guy at a UFO conference, a big one, that I was speaking at one time on the media and UFOs. My topic was media and UFOs. And this person was his wife, English chap, really nice guy, that... eventually made contacts with me and his friends in the CIA who wanted to tell the truth, but they couldn't because they lose their pension. Hey, Tippy Toes, good to see you. Good to see everybody out there. Hope you're having a good morning, a good night, a good day, wherever you may be. This is the way. So this is the ticket. We are going into a beautiful transformation, even though the world seems crazy, I know, on Earth, we are actually going into a great transformation. Hey, and that's going to be the most beautiful thing for all of us. Hey, Realms 247, dear Aber, Drew Aber, Witness, thanks for the likes. User 829, welcome. And as we look at the future, I'm really more psyched about what we're going to reveal with you on Saturday night, you see. And you should be excited about Saturday night's broadcast. You should be. Is anyone not excited about Saturday night's broadcast? Do you know what I mean? Do you know where the commander is going with this? Do you understand where we're going? Are you aware of what's happening Saturday night? Anybody? This is a test. This is a test to see if you're excited. If you're watching the show, you'll know what's happening. I'm not referring myself as a second person. I'm Commander Alion. I'm the first person. Commander Alion is not the second person. There's only one Commander Alion, and that's me too. There's no seconds or thirds or fourth. You know, if there's a duplicate of me, I like to find it. But it's actually, though, just kidding around. Yeah, I'm just Commander Commander Alion, the first person. Let's see here. I'm just looking at people's comments here. We're not going in a ship. Not that night. Not on April 13th. We're not going on a ship. At least I'm not aware of that happening. We are actually going to do a C5, which is an Astral Command C5 contact gathering. No, we're not going on a ship. Unless we are being surprised and I don't know what's happening, all I know is we have 7 Astral Command spaceships that will visibly be appearing over where we're going to be. And we're not supposed to be going on a ship. We're just going to be recording live on our TikTok the spaceships. So we're days away from that occurring on next Saturday on the 13th. And the commander is getting himself prepared on a level of consciousness for that night. I'm already prepared. I'm already excited for whatever the surprise is. We're all excited. We're all excited. And you, wherever you are in the world or country, you'll be able to watch whatever we have. Mods, please remove Michelle. Let me go back. What's Michelle doing? Okay, no, we're not, what's Michelle doing about readings? No, we're not doing readings. We're going to mute Michelle. You can't use my show to have people inbox you for readings, Michelle. I just muted Michelle. That's spamming. My show is not to be used for getting readings and getting people to go away from here for readings. No spammers. Don't do it. Don't try to do it on my show. Just because my show is popular doesn't mean you get to come in here and ask people to go to you for readings. Not happening. So will you go from UFO to UFO to IFO? Well, we're not going really anywhere, Wanderer. We're going to be recording the UFOs, the spaceships. 7 Astral Command ships. We'll be recording them on Saturday night. And, oh no, I didn't even realize it. Thank you. Once I saw what she was doing about the readings, I took her right out. I muted her for the whole show, giving her a chance to rethink about what she's doing. No, we're connecting to our galactic family. Yes, Connie, that's what we're going to be doing. But we're going to be visually recording the show. We're going to have our whole group there. It could be a bot, too. Yeah, that's right, Alicia. And look, I'd be really surprised if something different is going to happen that we don't know about. You know, there's a lot of the Astral Command's working on a lot of levels to help our planet right now, off planet. There's a lot of work they have to do. And the last thing they're thinking of, or the first thing they're thinking of, is that night taking us on ships. But you know what? I can be completely wrong about this, and we are supposed to be in for a surprise. Okay. So I have no idea other than 7 ships are going to be there. Oh, really, Sandra? Interesting. Well, I did mute her, and I will block her if that continues. Thank you. You know, so these things that are happening, you know, it would be, Spirit, it would be wonderful, but I've learned that what we're going to do is have that happen in 6 months. By September, we're supposed to be going on the ship. Like I said, I don't think it's going to happen Saturday night, but I could be in for a surprise that I don't even know about. I don't think they're doing it. You know, and again, there's no astral beings. We don't deal with astral beings whatsoever. We're talking about the Ashtar Command. So we don't deal with any astral beings whatsoever. No astral beings on TikTok. The Ashtar Command, the space family that we belong to, they're on ships, so they won't be appearing on TikTok. What we're going to do is record the spaceship Saturday night, and whatever else happens, we're going to record it live, and we'll be broadcasting live on our TikTok. So, yeah, that's the plan this coming Saturday. And I'll be spending Friday relaxing, getting centered, just preparing for Saturday night. So there's a lot of inner reflections and so forth I'll be doing Friday. Will you start at 8 p.m.? Yes, we're going to start at 8 live, but I'm going to try to get the people together a half hour before then, before we go live. I think I'm going to have people arrive about 7:30 p.m. Saturday. The spaceships are already here around our planet, Librina. We will have, if everything goes to plan, we have 7 Ashtar Command spaceships that will be appearing as a gift. For my belated birthday, they'll be showing up for my belated birthday. So that would be happening on Saturday night. My birthday was in February. Hey, Paranormal Ghostbuster, good to see you. So there's a lot going on here that's interesting because, like I said, all we know is it's a surprise. We know that. Mariano in Las Vegas, good evening. Welcome to the show. Thank you for the roses, Paranormal. I have set a goal here. I have 1 of 8 baseball caps taken. I would like to get all the caps taken. Hey, Susan Murray, good to see you. I'm not at all shy about asking for TikTok gifts on my show for the work I'm doing, and I have been doing ever since I come up here last year. Become a subscriber. 33 of 100 subscribers now subscribe to my TikTok. That money from there is going towards night vision equipment for our group that will be communally used by our CE5 group. Okay? Just so you know. Victoria, thank you for the lightning bolts. We appreciate every little thing, no matter what kind of gift it is. Thank you. I appreciate you so much. I appreciate everybody, you know. My whole frequency is the frequency of cosmic love and understanding. Being that I work with the Ashtar Command, I come from that frequency off planet, and I've integrated that energy ever since I was a kid. That frequency of love. Jay, yes, you did. So the commander is good at sharing and talking here. I know how to communicate information. Yeah, Virginia, good to have you. Mary Pohl, good to have you with us. Actually, also last week my tire blew and have to pay for repairs, so I wasn't able to send the muffins. No problem. You got to take care of the car, Ashley. You do what you got to do. How to love when people hurt you? I can answer that question. Now, it depends how they're hurting you. Well, hurting anybody is no good. If it's mentally hurting people or verbally hurting people, what you have to do is be stronger than that person. The one thing I teach coming from off planet is as you stand in your spiritual light, your cosmic light, your foundation of light, no matter whatever any human says to you that's hurtful, you have to be the better person always. You have to be the person that takes the higher mountain. If that person takes the lower mountain, you go higher up. You know what? You become like a shield of light around you. So if someone tries to verbally hurt you, you don't let it happen. You say, you know what? I'm sorry you feel that way. You must be going through a lot of pain inside you. I still love you. And if they see you saying you love them, then that's going to either excite them more or they're not going to understand why you love them after what they did. It doesn't mean you have to be with them or associate with them. But you have to be that person of love. We all do, right? That's what coming from our planet's about. When we come from other planets, when I worked at the Ashtar Command, which I've been doing ever since I came to Earth and before Earth, all the planetary systems don't have these problems because they all live in harmony with each other and love with each other. On Earth, there are problems. Yeah, you can send them love and keep your distance, Krista. Just stay distant from them. Send a frequency of love. And if they're not about love, you don't have to be around them. You have the free will to say, I'm not going to be around you. You're not love. So you want to be with people that are love. And you actually will find a lot of people here on my show out there all around the world that are about love, about light, about understanding, you know. Many different people that are starseeds here that have come from other planets. This is a great place to be on encounters. Because we'll show you support where you weren't getting it. You're not alone here. Nobody is. Not on my show. I just want to smoke with other beings and show love. I don't think smoking is what the other beings do. They don't smoke. So if you're going to be with space people, you want to throw out the smoking and just clear your body, which is your cosmic temple. Get rid of the smoking. You don't need it. You know, if you're going to, you know, deal with space people, they don't smoke. So as an Earth person, you're going to have to shift your consciousness from smoking to not smoking before you make contact with any star people anywhere in the universe. You know what I mean? And that is the cosmic. I know you're kidding. I kind of knew that by the comments you were making. The only smoke you're going to have to smoke is the smoking of love and light. Now, that's a different kind of smoke. Maripol says, I'm alone. You did get me, gotcha. King, you got me, King Boogie. Very good. Booty something, welcome to the show. Joe Clearance 712, welcome to the show. Kelly Cummings, welcome. Deborah Smith. The Big Homie, welcome to the show. There's some people with interesting names. Cassandra, I think it is. I am a star person, don't smoke, don't drink. Coach Queen, good to see you, Coach Queen. And I'm glad everyone's here. I'm not going. I love my hippie calories. 151D version 2.0. Hey, if you love your hippie calories, who's to, you know, complain about that? Hey, Tara, good to see you. I think it's Binta, great risings to you. Good to see everybody coming in here. And if you have if you've been visited by ETs, if you've been visited by star people, if you've seen Bigfoots, if you've had fairies, you know, involved in your life, if you've had mer people involved, you're welcome to join us here. And to be a guest on the show, you have to be over 18, over 200 followers for audio. If you have 1,000 followers, I'd be happy to have you on here. And, 151, okay. If you want to be interviewed, the requirements are that you have to be over 18, no foul language, no smoking of any sort, no drinking, drugs, or being drunk on my show, and no paranormal discussion at all. That there's 10,000 other TikTokers that do that. We're real focused here on the cosmic galactic area, always, you know. Nope, that's right, King. That's right. So it's been, it's interesting tonight. Now, as the flow goes, somebody will tell me a story, and then I'll usually bring them up if they have a story that's worthwhile. I'll usually bring them up, and they can tell their UFO sighting stories. Certainly, we've had people recently have been on going on ships and having contact with star people recently, and that's pretty amazing. There's a lot of that going on, too. A lot of it. So tonight, you know, most nights have been pretty busy with interviews. Tonight seems to be a little bit slower. Star people are fact, not make-believe. That's true. But I got to go see you shortly. And Coach Queen, I'm going to follow you. Well, actually, I can't follow you because you have your following thing. Your settings on private, so you have to change that so I can follow you. But I got to go see you shortly. Okay, Coach Queen, take it easy. Have a good night. So as we are here together, we're looking at the next few months where there's increased amounts of sighting. It was stated even last year that 2024 was going to be a year of increased sightings. Tara, definitely blessings to you. And there's going to be increased sightings as the weeks and months go by this year. Many people are going to have sightings. I'm pretty sure of it. I sent you a video of a farmer taking a video of two orbs in action, creating a crop circle. I'll have to take a look at that there, Ashley. I appreciate you sending me the video. And if I have nobody to interview, which is unusual, we'll see here. I'm really kind of stumped that we have nobody who has a story tonight. No new people, nobody. Don't be shy here. If you've got over 200 followers and you have a UFO story to tell, I'd love to hear it. Commander of a TikTok, Commander, TikTok is discontinued, and I hope it's not. You can always move over to Capper. TikTok's not going anywhere. Number one, it has to go through the Senate, and the Senate is not going to allow TikTok to be banned. Congress is trying to ban TikTok, but this has to go through the U.S. Senate, and it's very unlikely that the U.S. Senate is going to sign a bill to allow that to happen. There's too much pressure, and they're going to get too much pressure from the American public and the world public, for that matter. So I wouldn't worry about it. I don't think the Senate's going to do anything except say no to the Congress, and we're going to be still where we are. So I wouldn't worry about it too much. The commander's not worried about it. Paranormal has a story. We'll bring Paranormal up if he has a spaceship UFO story. Absolutely. So let's see what Paranormal Ghostbusters has a story about. And we're going to bring, and Paranormal, we'll bring you on here if you're able to come up on audio. And
how are you?
How you doing, Paranormal Ghostbusters?
Oh, quite good. I want to share something about where my brother, he's like his disability. He lives in a special home for the, you know, it's called a hospital. But it's, they take care of handicapped people. And when I visit my brother and I went to his room, then we saw a little fairy.
You did?
Yeah, and I think to myself and I thought, am I seeing things or not? But we told other people, but they didn't want to believe me. That mm-hmm. We told the staff and they said, no, it's no fairies. And I said, I seen something, but they said to me, well, they told me that I'm dreaming and so-and-so, so.
Oh, the staff people told you that?
The staff where they look after the handicapped people.
Well, yeah, they long time that's ago. The, yeah, they can't, yeah. They just can't see what you see, you know, unless they yeah. are open to it, they're not going to see the fairies, but if you see the fairies, you're open. You're open in your consciousness, you can see them.
So see, you know, because you can there. See. Yeah, my brother was there and he was in the room. We visit him every weekend and because there was a lot of handicapped people, they got problems to the world and, you know, I always go there and visit him and I only saw a little fairy once.
Really? Did he say what the fairy looked like?
Hands. And it's got mm-hmm. like a little, it's very tiny hands and
yes.
little head and little yeah. wings. And
little wings.
It's like a quick. And I saw a little face and I thought, if I had a camera, I would have taken a snapshot, but I didn't have no mm-hmm. Camera to take a shot of it.
And what did the fairy do? Were you communicating with the fairy at the time or what happened?
Pardon?
Say again?
Yeah, he was visiting all handicapped people, you know, and I'm sure that the star people and are protecting people who are handicapped and, you know, who got disability.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sure they are. I'm sure they are.
That's why
So
I'm,
the
yeah. And that's
fairy
how I
was.
start to become a belief.
Ah, okay. And the fairies that you were seeing, the fairy was visiting all these people that were handicapped, which is a beautiful story, you know.
Because my,
Absolutely.
because
You
now
gotta
he lives in a group home. He lives in a group home now, in a different place now. And not only that, when I was asleep at my mum's place, I feel like I was awake, and I feel like a force, like a hand, trying to grab me. And I was feeling fear. And when the hand trying to grab me, I was trying to push away, but he just grabbed my hand and hold my hand. And then I didn't want to say what it is because I'll be freaking out. But I can't work it out. Who's doing that?
You're asking me
We
who's
don't
doing that
know that was
touching?
a star people.
Can you refer? Could you
Yeah, I was
go?
aware, I was awake, but
Okay, so
the
you were
boss, I
when
was
this? What
doing
year
that
did
one.
I hear the rooster there? That's amazing, the rooster thing. The rooster's doing its thing. That you got? What, you on a farm? Are you on a
Yeah, I
farm?
live in like a jungle area.
You live in a
Yeah,
jungle
I'll
area.
turn my
All
camera on
right.
so you can see me.
Okay, try. There you are. Oh, there you go. Keep the camera on.
A
That's
player.
good. There you go.
Yeah,
Good.
see,
There.
this is my this is a
Oh, you
jungle
got.
commander.
Yeah, jungle. Wow, you're in a jungle. You're not kidding. Look at that. How
Plenty
beautiful that
snakes.
is.
Yeah,
Yeah,
but
this is
sometime
now.
in nighttime we
And you're in the Philippines, correct?
In Philippines, this ground here gets flooded out. That when it's flooding, we get a lot of earthquakes. Mountain up the top there, and it's a sky gray. We've got pigs.
Well, you're in a good area for, look at that. You're in
Say
a good
hello to
area for,
Commander. Jen, say hello to Commander. Say
Hello?
hello. Hello. She's
Hello?
shopping.
Okay. So, yeah, see? This is beautiful. So, yeah, I mean, I think you're in a spot. Can you go back about the story about the star person possibly touching you? When did that happen? What year was that?
Oh, happened when I was about 19 years old.
19. So,
Yeah,
I mean,
and I
obviously
was
you're not 19
sleeping
now,
on the
but.
ground. I was sleeping on the ground on the floor, but it was too hot sleeping on the bed. And suddenly I was awake, and I felt something like a big force. It's like touching my hand, and I keep pushing away, but it keeps coming towards me. And I told people about that for taking medication. That's what they said to me.
Yeah. So did the star, this possible star, you're asking me whether you had a star person when you were a little kid, I guess. No, well, not a kid, you were a young adult, teenager. That when did that happen? What was, can you give a detailed information in terms of, I guess what I'm thinking of is, what did you see, what who it was at the time it happened? Did you get a visual or
I
no?
couldn't work it out. I was like open my eyes, but slowly it was quite white, like a beautiful light, but I couldn't work it out what it is. I didn't want to see the head. I just saw something bright. It's hard to describe it, do you know?
Was
Like
it
if you look in the sky,
right, was the body, how
like
tall was the light? Can you say how tall it was?
it looks like someone's wearing a robe.
A
And
robe,
it's white,
okay.
beautiful robe. Yeah, it's
Okay,
more
that gives me.
different, better cutting than earth.
Yeah, now I'm reading, now I can read into your story. Now I'm reading into it. So the being that was with the white robe had to be over 7 feet tall, at least 7 feet. It was a tall
Yeah,
light, like,
totally. Yeah.
yes, tall.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm reading into your energy now about that story. So now that I'm defocusing on the rooster, I can actually say that With the Roban, a tall being of light. Roban, tall being of light. Yeah, you were being visited
Roban.
by a star person. Yes, you were. There was
Yeah,
radiating
and I
a
did
light
Roban
around the
back.
body. Yeah, yeah,
Yeah.
yeah. It was definitely a star being. I don't know where they came
Yeah.
from, but the star being can transcend time and space. Meaning, when the star being wants to visit, if it was you or anybody here and watching the show, the star people have the ability to just be right there. Right there in the same vicinity,
Yeah.
the same location you are.
Yeah, because I didn't
another
have
a person.
anyone to talk about.
Yeah. Well, there's somebody here in the United States. This is Commander. He saw the same thing my wife saw. She described the same man made of light and white robes. So you're not alone. We have somebody here in the United States who had the same exact experience. Karen Morgan says, how did he feel after the star being touched him? Good question. So can you tell us, one of our audience people are saying, how did you feel when you were being touched by that star person afterwards?
I feel good when it touched me, but at first it was scary, but like my heart was beating so fast, and but when it touched me, and then after that, this let go, and then things came back to normal. Like I had no control of my body. I couldn't move my body. I'm aware. You know, I can see, but I couldn't move my body completely.
Right.
It's just like something control your body, like, you know, like a force coming towards
Did
my hand.
you feel like you were, it's just you that, because you were so like startled by it, I think you were startled, correct, at the time? Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you were startled by that experience, even though the star being was with the white robe and everything, was it's just that your reaction, your mind's reaction was, wait a minute, what's going on here? Because it wasn't something you expected, right? You didn't expect it, correct? So it just happened. So here's how I'm going to help you. I think you need to reconnect with that star being, now that I'm reading into your story. And if you want to ask me, how do you do that? If you, because you have a memory of the white robe and the tall being with the white robe on, it is a star being, it is a light being, it is a positive being of light. So now that I'm tuned in really strongly, if you meditate, and I know you can, meditate on the images of that light being and just use the word I teach people to use when I talk to people to help people, that I'm a Christed being of light on earth, and I wish to, I wish to reconnect with the star being that I interacted with. I wish to know who your name is, and I wish to know what planetary system you came from. So you need
My
to ask
name
very
is
specific.
Marshall.
Your name is
Marshall,
but you need to ask the space being what their name is. So what I want you to do is meditate, focus on that star being with the robe, the radiant light that was taller than you, and try to find out who they are. And you can do that in a, you know, do like a 30-minute meditation maybe per day. And you know, and as you focus on that, without the rooster doing what it's doing in a quiet space, you'll and the rooster, because the rooster will distract you.
That's
you'll be
idea.
Where's the rooster? We have to teach that rooster. We have to teach the rooster how to meditate. That's going to be a big thing to do. No, but for you,
but
seriously,
I never experienced. UFO, only the one I was telling you, little fairy, and the, you know, I've been touched and all that. But I had some kind of supernatural gift to sometime. I don't know, it's just come automatic, hard to explain. When I was in a relationship in Australia, and I walked around, I looked at the tires, and then I knew one of the tires was going to come undone. But if I told them, they wouldn't believe me. Anyway, we went for a drive, and on Sunday, one of the tires came undone. And I thought, I was imagining. I don't know how I knew. It's
that's
like
because,
something I knew things. And
no, that's called the psychic ability. That's what that is. Like, my psychic ability is more cosmic and galactic. Your ability is to know things, to prevent something from happening before it happens. You know it. That's what that was. You had a premonition of before that tire did its thing. If they had listened to you, that's real. You know, that's a psychic ability. There's all kinds of psychic abilities. Me, it's off planet. My psychic abilities I'm more driven on a galactic scale. I'm not more earth-based as I am more galactic. Your abilities that you've been given are activated, so you can actually, if someone had listened to you about the tire, then you could have gone to a tire place and had tried the tire changed, and that wouldn't have happened. But sometimes people don't listen to those things, you know? It's just human nature.
A lot of people don't listen. Yeah. Yeah, at some point, I only go out there and look at the stars. If I see anything unusual, I take pictures of it. You know, I'm trying to keep eye if I see any UFO. I know one of my friends on TikTok seen UFO, but I said to him, did you take a picture? And they said, no. Oh, bummer. I wish I was a lucky one to see one, but I'm not that lucky.
You know what? It's not so much the UFO paranormal that's important. It's your connection to that star being that connected with you at 19 years old. Focus on that. Don't worry about the UFO. You know, focus on that? Yeah, that's what I want you to do. Because the reason why I want you to do that is it will help you reconnect with that space being and find out where they're from. And you'll have a beautiful experience. If you can work on that, give it a few weeks. But if you can work on that and come back and say, Commander, I did exactly what you suggested and I made contact with that space being, I guarantee you, you'll have more information. That space being was just initially contacting you. And I'm sure, I mean, they're doing their thing wherever they are in the universe. But if you are willing to meditate and focus on them, they will reconnect with you. Absolutely.
Is it good Jay to play meditation song?
I would use like higher dimensional music. If you have YouTube, you can get higher dimensional frequency music or Christ consciousness ambient music and put it low and just meditate and focus. The music will help you and put you in a frequency state is a very high level. Okay. So I always use that music. Even on my radio show, I'll play ambient higher dimensional music on my show on Sunday mornings when I'm talking about space people and so forth. I always like to play music that brings people to a state of consciousness that is much, much higher than where they are at that point. And it really helps. It'll help you too. And you have a very pure soul. Just to let you know, as I read your energy, you're a very pure soul. So you have a lot of abilities in you that have been gifted to you. You have a lot of light energy in you. Do you realize that? Do you know you have light energy in you? You know what I mean by light energy? You have a lot of light energy. Your light energy shines brightly. And if you focus on the inner reflections of yourself, you will amplify your energy even higher than it is now. It will. It'll go much higher. So you have a beautiful energy. Focus on the space being with the robe. Meditate for 30 minutes a day and focus, focus, focus. And you will eventually make reconnections with them. I want to know what happens in a few weeks from now. When you come back to the show, you're going to say, Commander, I got the name of the person. I know who they are. I know where they're from. I know my connections to them. I'll be very excited to hear your story when you have that come about. So I appreciate you for coming on here. All right, dear paranormal. Thank you so much.
Commander. I appreciate being watching you a lot.
Thank you for coming on here.
I was falling asleep last night. I missed half of your show. I was falling asleep. I was trying to keep awake because it was nighttime here when about 10 o'clock at night and it was morning where you are. And I thought, I feel bad because I said to April in the message because I thought I can't keep trying to keep awake to watch Commander's live.
Well, all my shows paranormal are on YouTube. So if you go to my YouTube channel, and that goes for anybody, Ashtar Command Spaceship News, all my shows, day and night shows, are recorded. You can watch every past show you've ever missed on there when you're awake.
Yeah. Can I say hello to all your star people?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, star people, if you're watching up the top there, hi.
They can hear you. They can hear you. They can also hear your rooster, the star people. They're on the ships listening to your rooster.
Make sure you come down for a cup of coffee one day.
You never know. They might just do that. Yeah. You know, you never know there.
I'll prepare the coffee for them.
You'll prepare the coffee for them in the jungle? That'll be good. I think they'll be happy with that.
Yeah, and make sure that I do it on live TikTok.
You'll do it on live TikTok? That'll be good. Well, you know, when we have mass contact, we'll make sure I'll talk to some of the people on the ship when I go there, and we'll try to plan out to have coffee in the Philippines off the spaceship. There you
If
go.
you do go up there, just tell give them my regards up there.
Well, we will. We'll give them your regards for sure. We're going up there soon, so
Yeah,
when
just
we go
say
off
Marshall
planet,
down
we'll.
Philippines said hello.
Okay, we'll definitely tell them that. We promise you. Okay. Hey,
Yeah,
Marshall, thank
all
you
right.
so much. You're a blessing, man.
You're
Okay?
welcome, Commander.
All right.
Yeah.
Am I good to have you with us?
Keep
And we
up
want
the
to
good
thank.
work.
Oh, we're going to keep trying to do the best we can, and you keep doing what you're doing out there too. All right. And that was Marshall in the Philippines. What a beautiful place. Not only that, we heard a rooster on the show. A rooster. Get that. We got to have a rooster on the show. Hey, Paranormal, thank you. Thank you, Marshall. And see, that's the beauty of my show is we have people watching this from all over the world, the Philippines, Europe, everywhere. Paranormal, thank you for the roses. I appreciate it. Oh, wait a minute. Meek Dag, the ghost. I just posted a YooHoo video I took tonight. Interesting. Seek knowledge. Meek the ghost, can you tell us about this UFO you took? Where are you located? Are you in the US, in Europe? Where are you located, Meek the ghost? Let's see here. And let's see. Half Pint says, I got one last night. Half Pint has recorded something too. Oh, you're in North Carolina. I'm going to bring up Meek the Ghost, and then Half Pint has a sighting she recorded. Here's the way our show works. Number one, you're over 18. Number one. Number two, no smoking of any sorts, no drinking, no drugs, no anything. Number three, no paranormal discussions. Number four, I think I said no foul language. And yeah, number five, no paranormal discussion. I think I covered everything. You got to be over 18. So we're going to bring up Meek the Ghost, and then Half Pint is coming up next. And we're going to see where this goes here. So I'm inviting Meek the Ghost on here as a guest on our show in North Carolina. Our second guest of the evening from the United States. I'm going to bring him back up because my TikTok thing is working kind of weird. Hold on a minute. Let me disconnect and bring you back up again. I'm not sure what's going on with the thing here. We'll try it again. And we're going to see if the TikTok thing works the way it's supposed to. Now it's working right. There you go. Sometimes the TikTok thing doesn't work right.
Hey, what's
So you're
up?
watching account. Hey, Meek the Ghost. Good to see you, brother.
Good to see you too, man.
And I hear you had a sighting.
Yeah, you remember I was on your show last time talking about it, you know.
Yeah, a while ago. Yeah.
You know
Yeah.
it.
It's been a while. So what's happening?
Well, you know, it's been a I'm on the phone. It's been the same thing every night. I experience this every night, you know, and they don't usually let me rec
They
they
don't
don't
usually let you record it.
Yeah, they like dim out when I pull out my cell phone. So, but tonight, you know, I think it has something to do with this eclipse thing. Like, you know, it wasn't what people really think it was, you know. So,
Yeah. And for
yeah.
your experience, and you do have these sightings every night. And one of the things we're finding out with people on the show that have regular sightings of spaceships that are around them all the time, that one of the things that the theory is, and I'm actually leaning towards it, is that they are star family. That the reason why they're with you all the time is they want to be with you all the time because you're connected to them. Have you thought about that idea? I know recently a number of people on my show have been connecting with their star family, their space family. Have you felt that feeling about the sightings you're having?
Well, you know, today, you know, a lot of things came into perspective today. Because, you know, I've been dealing with this for 2 years now. For 2 years, I've
Yeah.
been having these. So, you know, I've come to terms with it. You know, I actually communicate with them. And so, you know, I know they mean me no harm. You know,
Right.
they. So, you know, I got a lot of knowledge from them. You know, see, but it's like telepathy. So sometimes you don't know if you're going crazy or not. You hear voices in your head. So, you know, it's like ciphering through static, you know, sometimes. So,
Right.
but
Well,
I actually.
telepathy, I was going to say telepathy is not going crazy. You have telepathic abilities, And the reason why, because you were born with those abilities when you came to Earth. The good part about that is, because I'm a telepathic person myself, is that it makes it easier because they communicate in telepathic words through mind-to-mind communication. So a lot of people here have that telepathy like you're talking about. A lot of my audience has that. So you're not crazy. That's normal. So that's a good thing. So go ahead. What were you going to say just now before I interrupted you regarding telepathy?
I kind of forgot, but, like you said, like there's my star family. And, I wholly and truly believe that, and like I said, it used to scare me back in the days when it first started happening. But, I've come to terms with it. And, I've been dealing. It's still a little scary seeing that. Like, it feel like, it feel like it'll really, scare the soul out of you, honestly. But,
Well, that's the human mind's the thing that's scared, not the spiritual person. The human mind wants to be scared. The
Absolutely,
human mind scares
I agree.
You. You know, if you get rid of your mind, well, I'm not saying get rid of your mind, but if you just take, I tell my mind, basically, be quiet. I tell the mind, don't go there. I tell my mind, stay out of the picture, and I've done really good at doing that. I control everything on my spiritual level, cosmic level, and the mind has no control over it at all. Once you put the mind in place where it's supposed to be, it'd say, okay, you don't want me to get scared? Okay, I'll stop doing that to you.
Absolutely.
That's all you got to do, right?
Right. And another thing, Commander, I actually think like for some, this is just my personal belief from what I'm seeing on TikTok. Because, today there was a lot of videos came out with people recording the stuff I've been seeing for 2 years now. And, I feel like I'm in contact with these beings, and they've been leading me up to this eclipse. Because I feel like during that eclipse, they were able to come into this realm a little more easier, or something that I don't know exactly what it is. I can't get it down. Like I said, it's like talking through static, but it's like something, man, I don't want to say a portal or whatnot, but something similar. It's like it's easier for them to come through. That's why all these sightings happen today. And then when I stepped outside, it's like, usually they come 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 over a span of 4 hours. They'll come back to back. But soon I step outside, they just there, boom, boom, boom. I say, oh, shit, they just,
what's happening is the eclipse, what I got from it was not really looking too much at it, is that the eclipse is real. This eclipse is really a shift in the frequency in the universe.
Absolutely.
Not just for Earth, but the whole solar system. So every planet in our solar system, everybody, when the eclipse happened, it shifted us into a higher frequency or high vibration, and that's why you saw all the ships. There were a lot of people saying to me, Commander, messaging me, say, I saw ships today. The reason why you're seeing more of it, because there is a switch over. It's like a switch was turned on during the eclipse.
Well, Commander, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. I just want to ask you a question. In the chat, I want to ask the chat and you a question. Like today, I noticed, I've seen a lot of other people say it in comments before. I felt it, but then I seen other people say it, and then my mom said something about it. So I said, okay, hold on. Like during the eclipse, like whatever time it was, I got real tired and real fatigued, and I heard people had headaches and stomach. It was like you said, something shifted, and a lot of people felt like real fatigued. I mean, I was real drained. Drained. Like I never. It just felt weird. And, then my mom said something. Then I seen someone on TikTok say it. Then I started reading the comments, and I seen hundreds of people saying, oh, I had a headache. Oh, my stomach was hurting. Oh, I was drained, tired. And then it clicked. Like, okay, so that shit, it definitely was a little shit. You see, I'm reading the comments. I was waiting for the comments to come, see if somebody else felt it.
Yeah. Everyone had different things. One person said they had vertigo. Me, I had nothing happen. It just basically, I look at it as being a shift. A very powerful shift in frequency for people watching our show here. I think the eclipse was basically everyone was looking at it from all different perspectives all over the world. But the thing with the eclipse is I think it's totally a shift in where we are before the eclipse and after the eclipse. I think as the days go on, people's energies are going to be feeling quite different than they were leading up to the eclipse.
No, I totally agree. Totally agree with that.
Yep. Well, man, it's good to have you on here. You need to, I think with your star family, I think you can make visual contact, meaning I think if you ask them to, and you communicate with them telepathically, which I know you do, say that I'm ready for contact. I'm a Christ being of light. If you're a Christ of beings of light and you're here to help me and help the planet, I would like to make contact with you and see what happens with that. But no, also, before you...
I'm sorry, good. I was listening.
Yeah, I was going to say, are you having what I call physical contact, where they are physically saying, here we are, not in any other state but the physical state, meaning if I were to knock on your door and I came off the ship, then I would say, I'm Commander so-and-so from the ship, so-and-so, our ship is in the field in your backyard. You know, I'm saying, would you have that specific kind of contact?
Well, Commander, the closest one I have, like I said, it scared me to death. The closest one I had is when, like you said, I went out there and I told him, I said, look, reveal yourself. Stop playing it. I want to see. And then, you know, it was like an orb 5 feet in front. It's not no orb up close. It's like as bright as a star. I mean, it was pure white. It was about the size. Right. The size of like a minivan, just tall and wide, but you couldn't make out no features. It was just brilliant light. And you know, like I said, that it scared me so bad. My heart stopped for a second. And then it felt me like the way my heart literally stopped. I stopped breathing and felt it and it left. And you know, since then, because I can call them out at will. Like I said, I do it for my friends. So you want to see aliens, and you know, I concentrate and they come out, but they stay at a distance. So, and I know, like, I asked them to reveal themselves and they had that effect on me. So I can imagine the effect it'd have on, because you know, people say we want to see aliens, but when you really see something like that up close, your mind can't comprehend it, and it could literally break your mind. You know, I asked for it.
You know what? This is the other thing. Forget the word aliens. You don't want, because they don't exist. But your experiences, and this is where my teachable thing is from my experiences. So you're having an experience with what I believe are light beings that can take shape, that can shape into their physical form like a human. But that orb that's as big as a minivan could be that they're in a different time and space. Right. So you're only seeing like the outer light of
like a projection.
A projection.
Commander, I promise you, I thought that same thing, because I talk to them and I sometimes they don't come out and I hear things in my head and I was getting like they projecting inside of this realm, but they're not really here type stuff, you know. So I actually thought that same exact thing.
Well, the thing is, they actually are here. It's just a matter of whether you wish to make contact. Like, for example, I'm going to bring my friend April up because I know she must have gone to sleep. But they can actually help you. They will help you. Then they can help you. I think that you just have to now tell yourself, I'm not afraid, that you, since you communicate with them telepathically, I think what you could do, and this is only a suggestion, is ask them tonight, say, well, you know, maybe even tomorrow, say, I am ready to make contact with the light beings that are connecting with me. I'm ready. I'm not going to be afraid. I wish to communicate with you. And I wish to, you know, I wish to, oh, she is still here. I didn't see her. Oh, there she is. I don't know why I don't see everybody. So this is my good sister friend, April in Vermont. And April, this is Meet the Ghost, who's sharing his story that he has constant contact for 2 years with a ship or ships that are over where he is in North Carolina. And he just shared a story of this orb, this light. And I am trying to suggest to him how to, you know, initiate communications. And I think you would be a great person to help, because you've been on the ship over 11 times with the Admiral Command. So what advice would you give the ghost?
First of all, the orb was actually them. It might have been, because it was so big, it might have been more than one being inside that light orb. That's how they travel and come to us, as to not startle us. With, you know, a human form just popped up in front of you, it would probably startle you, correct? So they come in this soft orb, and it was probably more than one being, which is why the orb was so big. It was probably like your star brother, sister, mother, maybe a couple of them, you know, that had come down to meet you because you've been asking to meet them.
Right.
So
that and you have for 2 years.
2 years. Hey, can I just say something to one of your group members, Alicia? She made a comment. It may help if you ask them to remember your relationship with them. I want to comment on that. I actually one of these days, probably in the last 2 years, I can't remember which day, how long ago, but actually had a past life experience. Like, and you know, they don't tell you seeing yourself in a past life is actually emotionally damaging, because you know, you see yourself in that past life and you remember it, and it's like, you know, you remember that you pulled away from that, and it damaged me a little bit. And inside of that past life experience, I seen myself from two different perspectives. And I had long gray hair, and I was smoking on a hookah, and I was waving my hands around, and I was making the stars move. So, you know, and that kind of helped me remember, just to answer your question, Alicia, that kind of helped me remember a little bit, seeing that past life, seeing me move my hands and the stars are moving at my command. It kind of gave me some understanding as to why I can call these things out. You know, like a shaman or something, or something close.
You
to
mean
that.
Not so much that. I think if you whatever the abilities you have, you've been gifted with them before you came to Earth.
Absolutely,
your abilities came with you to Earth, just like my abilities I have now. And you've watched my show enough to know that I can do some cosmic things here.
Right,
I've sent spaceships over to people that were being negatively interacted with negative ETs, and we got rid of the ETs and we got them off planet. And I've done that since last year. I've done it probably over a dozen times. So, you know, that's the thing, is to realize that, you know, you have control of the situation. And I think what April is saying too, is about your cosmic family is in that, what you consider to be the size of a minivan, inside there may be way bigger than the orb itself. Just like we describe, a spaceship on the outside might look small, but on the inside it could be way bigger than what we think it is.
That's actually a pretty cool concept.
Yeah.
They have come down to me in the orb form as well, and then they walked out of the orb, and it was huge. It was almost like a soft white light that had come down one time, and then the other time it was a blue, it looked like a giant drop of water coming down, and they stepped right out of it. It's how they sometimes how they travel down from the ships, depending on what ship they're in.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say, Jay, no, I actually lost my father when I was three. She asked if I lost someone when I was young. Yeah, my father died when I was three. But yeah, that kind of, you know, that like a big raindrop is kind of what it resembled too. Like, if you want to say a mini size raindrop, because like I said, it had no form and no shape. It was just a brilliant white light. And
I was going to say the radiant light of the brightness, as you describe it, is in that big orb that was the size of a minivan. I definitely read that inside that bright orb, which actually, if you're inside the orb, is way bigger than what it appears to be to you from an outside looking in.
So right.
I would suggest to meditate on it. Like when you get a free minute, you know, somewhere quiet, do some meditation on it and prepare yourself to meet them. If that's what you truly want to do, is to meet your star family, prepare yourself for it. And know that most of them are very, very humanoid looking. Some of them are very tall, but they are kind, kind, loving beings.
Right.
And they're, you know, they will at first communicate with you telepathically, but when they're in front of you and doing that, it's a lot more clear in your head than it is when they are, you know, from far away and then trying to sift through and think that you're crazy, you know, because I know those voices. You know, so I would suggest meditating on it, preparing yourself for contact with them, and then ask to see them. You know, go out and do what you do, however you get them to come to you, and then go out and ask for them to come to you.
Yeah. I'm gonna be honest with you, Abel. It's like gonna be honest. It's like I don't even ask them to come. It's like they're always. I mean, I look out my window right now and I see. I can't sleep at night because I know they're above. I have this pattern of stars above my house that don't move all night. It sits there. I watch. I'm outside all night every night. I can't sleep no more. And I watch the. It's like six stars that's above my house. They don't move. It's in a little pattern. I try to look for the pattern. Yeah, I tried to look for the pattern in some books, but I can't find that. I even looked in the Hebrew language to try to see that if I seen that pattern. But yeah, they definitely follow me. Like they don't, they always hear like I can.
Right, but I think what April's saying is to be more intimate is that, excuse me, it's time. Actually, I'm feeling it's time for you after 2 years that they're close to you. Your family wants to make contact with you. They're waiting for you to say yes. And not that you're hedging away from it, but you're aware they're there. But
I
now
keep
you
a
have
distance.
To make
yeah, I
don't keep
a distance. I'm be honest with you, Commander. It's, you know, I go out there and I try to pray. I don't meditate as much as I should, but when I do go out there, I tell myself like don't be scared, don't be scared. But it's, you know, being by myself out there and it's the not knowing that's scary. Like, but I know they're good because I felt the love radiating off them.
Here's what I want you to do. I want you to get out of your mind and not be scared. I want you to, before you go out, I want you to do a meditation for yourself to get yourself into a state of peaceful consciousness to say, I am not scared to connect with my cosmic family. I know you're good. I am willing to take the step, even in the darkness of night, that you'll go out there and they will come to you. You don't have to go out in the woods or anything. Just go outside and be there and say, I'll stand here. I'm ready to meet my cosmic family. I'm not afraid. And if you do that, if you're willing to do that, I believe that you will have the most beautiful experience you've ever had for the first time in your life.
Well, that sounds so great.
Can you do that?
Love coming from radiate right into you.
Listen to April. April lives up in the North Country, up in Vermont, near the Canadian border. When she first had the encounters with the Star People, her family, and then she met my family on the ships, she went out there, and she has a trail, and they met her. And she's been on the ships 11 times with our Ashtar Command families. And, you know, she's a good one to give you advice because she has been through the experience at night. And so I'm going to turn it over to her to help you understand not to be afraid when you go outside at night to finally meet them.
But trust me, I get the human fear side of it because the very first time they came to me, I opened up my door and one was standing right there. And I'm from California, so, you know, I know about, you know, right. A little thumb. But, you know, it's like when I open, I live in the mountains now, so when I opened up the door, I definitely wasn't expecting anybody to be standing there. So I slammed the door in this poor being's face, and
She slammed the door on the space being who was human from the Ashtar Command. And now she had no idea who it was. I mean, she's down in the woods, you know, so that, I still think that's funny when she tells that part of the story.
So they ended up coming back a few. I yelled. I was like, come back. I'm sorry. After I realized who it was, because like I guess I'd kind of been preparing for it for a long time. And after I realized who it was, and I was like, no, come back. And then they waited a few days to let me calm down. And then they came back. And of course, you know, I had word vomit. I'm like you, like I get overexcited and everything comes flying out of my mouth at one time, you know, because I was overexcited. And he shushed me. He like straight shushed me. He put his finger to my head and was like, shh, you know, and I was like, okay. Yeah. But, you know, after that, then I was able to calm myself and ask him questions. And we just walked and he took me with him, told me I had work to do. And, you know, he had other things to say to me, but. You know, that was the start of my contact with them. And, you know, I've been on several ships and traveled all over the world, underneath the world, underneath the water. I've been to a lot of places that are so magical. Like, it's just going to absolutely blow your mind. Like, it is such an amazing experience to go through.
Well, you know, I was going to just say something, not to interrupt anybody. April, are you on that special phone for some
reason?
That's
why I was laughing. I was trying to tell you earlier that they were. That's why your stuff was going weird. My internet went weird, and then I heard laughing, and I heard him say rooster.
Oh, they said they were fine. Yeah, they. So you have to understand, April's on one of her two phones, and they're listening. They always watch the show. Mm-hmm. But I almost, as you're talking, I feel like they're communicating in English on the ship. Mm-hmm. Either that or something else is happening.
No, I'm in a dead silent room right now.
Oh, you're good. Okay, you're in a dead silent room. Okay. But it's definitely the amplification of energy is very, very coming through. Mm-hmm. But anyway, that's happening. Anyway, I don't want to get myself too far off of this thing. But yeah, that's what April's saying is very true. And I think if you... Go ahead.
No, I was gonna say, April sound like we kin to each other. When she said she begged for them to come back, I swear you sounded just like me, April. Because I get scared, and then you know I don't see him for a day or two. I kind of start begging, like you know, for them to come back.
Yeah, and that's the way I was. I was like, you know, I'm from California. You don't expect, you know, you expect drive-bys at 3 o'clock in the morning. You don't expect to see a space being come standing at your front door. You know.
Right.
So,
yeah.
So that startled me, you know, that's your human side of human fear, you know, but after I realized, after I shut the door or slammed the door, I realized who it was. And then I opened it up and they were gone. I was so mad at myself, but then they came back. They came back on their own. Within 2 nights they came back, and that's when I saw that big drop come down. Then I knew it was them coming, you know, and I was so excited. Like I had a million questions. I had word vomit. Like I would just come flying out my mouth. I didn't even give them time to answer the first question before I asked.
Oh yeah. More. She was going a mile a minute with them too. So you really, I think if you listen to what April's saying, what I'm saying, I would go out there one night when you have your kids put to sleep or whatever, and go out there and, well, first meditate before you do it. Center yourself, focus. And then when you get centered and focused, go out there and say, I'm now ready without being afraid to meet my star family. I'm a Christ of being of light. I'm here to welcome you, and I'm finally willing to meet you. And I bet you if you do that in the next few weeks, get yourself prepared mentally through meditation, I think it's going to be a beautiful story that you'll have in the future to tell, that you'll say, Commander or April, someone, I just met my star family. They came to me. They showed me their form, and they showed me who they were. And I think if you do that, you will have a most beautiful experience, absolutely without a question.
No, I'm definitely going to try that, Commander. I would do it tonight, but, you know, I'm actually going to a funeral tomorrow. So kind of packing, but I'm definitely going. And, you know, I'm going to be honest with you. Let me ask you a question, Commander, because – and you too, April. And I know you said you've seen him walking around. Since you know, during these past 2 years, right? Like right now, for instance, like let's say if I drive, it is like they follow me no matter where I go. But then I started seeing I could go to a random park, and if they got, I started seeing these like eyes in the woods follow. It's like bright eyes in the woods, like, and I see like a beam of light in the woods, you know. And it, I mean, it scares me to death. Look,
that might be because you were so open. You were also probably seeing fairy beings as well, dimensional beings.
I think so too.
So if you're like by the woods in nature in a park, and you're starting to see all these like weird little eyes or little glowing bodies floating around or little flashing lights, it's because you were so open that you probably can see dimensional beings as well.
That is so scary.
It is. They are loving beings. These are fairy folk. They're fairies, and they're
Don't be scared. Yeah, you see, the word "scared" is a big part of your vocabulary.
I know.
You've got to change that vocabulary to "I'm not scared." I'm not scared.
I'm working on it, Commander. But like I said, you know, I sleep with my window open. I'm in front of my window now. I'm always looking in the skies, and right behind my house is woods, like. And all through the night, every night, I see these eyes running through the woods. I mean, if I could tell you some of the things, I mean, I seen an orange face light up in the woods. Like, it was like maybe 7 to 8 of them. Like, because, you know, I asked for them to show me them. And even when I'm in my room, I want to see, I feel naked without them neighbors. It's like I feel, like, lonely.
Yeah, those are light beings. They're part of the fair folk. Those are good. They're the good folk, fairy folk. That's why my thing is friends with fairies. That's how I've been able to see fairies for years since I was little. I've known fairies my whole life, and interdimensional beings, Bigfoot beings, UFO. You know, I see them all. But my first experiences were with fairies.
Well, can let me ask you this? Being this open, can you attract negative beings when you're this wide open?
Absolutely.
Well, let me say that, and then I'll have April answer it.
That one.
Okay. The one thing you need to do, and I'm a stickler for this because I work in Christ consciousness. I come from off planet. I'm with the Astral Command. You need to just focus on Christ consciousness with your contact.
Right.
We know that the beings that you're dealing with are good, but you have to work in Christ consciousness, meaning that you have to say, I am a Christ of being of light. The only contact I will have with you if you are Christ of beings of light. And by saying that, you'll know if they're Christ of beings of light or not. But in this case, I don't feel any negativity in what you're going through.
Right.
The thing about the orb and all this other stuff. I think you always have to put a bubble of protection around your property and say, this is a Christed base of light. I am a Christed being of light, and I do not allow any negative ETs to come onto my property area. And if you are, and then when you put that Christed bubble around you, it can be an imaginary bubble. I guarantee you the only contact you're going to have ever is the space beings that are light beings that are actually trying to visit you. But you have to get rid of the fear. But in changing from the fear to the Christed levels of light, that will allow you to facilitate the communications by that same frequency, if you understand what I mean.
No, I absolutely do. Absolutely.
A lot of people don't do this. They, you know, they in this case, you're having positive contact. But even that being said, until you get rid of the whole verbiage of being scared, that is what's preventing you from having contact. They want to have communications with you. They want to physically meet with you, but you're just getting too scared when you don't need to be.
I'm gonna be honest with you, Command. Like I said, I might go out there and say I'm ready, tell myself I'm not scared, but it's always that little seed inside of my brain that, you know, that little
shut. You have to tell that little seed to just shut up. You know, that frankly, that's all you have to do. You control your brain. I control my brain. My brain never controls me. That's one of my teachings. Control your brain. Don't let it control you. The brain can be your worst enemy in these situations. You
right.
control the brain and just tell it nicely, please be quiet. I'm done hearing you telling me to be afraid. And just go about doing what you need to do. Just go with the center of your being in meditation, which is where it's at. And as you meditate in that Christ consciousness, you can now be ready to make contact. And I think if you give it some time in the next 2 or 3 weeks, focus on that. And I think that would be very helpful to you. I'll turn it over to April if she has anything she wants to suggest beyond what I just said. I'm going to let April talk.
So I completely agree with the commander. You do have to put that protection around you. And while you're doing it, also put it around your house and put it around your family. Just push that big bubble of protection as far out as you can. That way that fear and all that stuff won't be attracting anything negative. But like the commander said, I also do not sense or feel anything negative that has been trying to make contact with you.
Yeah,
I feel like
either.
These are all good beings.
Yeah, they're definitely good. I sense that too. It's just the, you know, the logical side of me. Like, you know, people think like stuff like this don't exist. That logical side that's saying this can't be possible, and
right.
sometimes it's just hard to comprehend still.
Well, you know what? You have to just say to the fear-based part of your mind and the logical part of your mind, please be quiet. I'm not listening to you anymore. I'm in control of my own destiny, my own light, my own being. And if you do that, that's the toughest victory you're going to have, is telling your mind, don't tell me to be afraid. Don't tell me to be logical. This is not logical. I don't need to listen to you anymore. I'm going to go meditate and make contact with the light beings that are trying to communicate with me. And they have their spaceships always around your house. They want to communicate with you, and you have to make that initiative. You have to make that step out, you know, to be able to do that.
I'm also say, Commander, it do kind of helps, you know, being able to talk to somebody about this, because, you know, just holding it inside, like, it's like a burden, kind of like, you know, not being able to, you know, to speak to people about it. And then you tell somebody, they just shrug you off like you crazy and whatnot. And, you know, I tell them, I could show you, like, you know, I've showed people this stuff. And, you know,
yeah.
And then I watch they react. When I show somebody, I watch their reactions, Commander. And it seemed like to me, like, they see it. But then it's like they don't really see it. Like you will go about your day like it never happened. And I can't live in normal society knowing I'm seeing what I'm seeing. And it just boggles my mind how you can see that and just act like right. you didn't see it. Like, you know, like.
Yeah, but if you, again, you're the most, you know, person that's, you're really into your brain part, which I read a lot. You need to get out of the brain part. It might not be easy at first, but it really is easy if you just tell the brain to stop.
You
say stop. That's all it is. The word stop is the key word. Do you think I work with I use my brain when I go into the supermarket or go into a restaurant or something, but I turn my brain off when I don't have to use it because on my cosmic level, I never use my brain, you know?
Right.
Oh, take care, friends of fairies. Have a good night. So I definitely did not use my brain. I used my consciousness in a centered cosmic way. Just like, for example, in the next few months, we're going to be physically going on, five of us on a spaceship together. Friends of fairies, April, you've probably heard her story. She's the initiator that was picked by the Ashtar Command, by our space family. And all over the world, there'll be groups of five people down the road that'll be going, whether it be the Philippines, Scandinavia, Hawaii, wherever it is, there'll be groups of five. And so that's why I'm, you know, because I've never been on the ship before. I'm not even afraid. I know that where I'm going is on a starship to meet my cosmic family, my mother, my father, my two sisters, and my brother. So you have to look at this. Once you allow yourself to let go of the brain, you'll have that contact. It'll be a beautiful thing, and you'll have a most beautiful experience.
No, I'm looking forward to it, Commander. I swear I am.
Well, we're getting up to about 1:30 in the morning. I usually get on at 11. I started late, so I'm a little bit off in my timing here tonight. But so this won't be the longest show I've had tonight. But I definitely want to thank you for coming up, Mika Ghost. And will you attempt to do the things we mentioned?
No, absolutely. I'm gonna be meditating okay. tomorrow after the funeral. I want to see him. I'm gonna meditate and I'm gonna go right on out there. Definitely.
All right. Well, you'll keep us in tune in a few days with what happens, and you know, definitely. Yes,
definitely will, all Commander.
Right. All right, brother. You take care.
We'll see you later. Yes, sir. All right.
And that's Meek the Ghost. Been on my show before. So one of the things I teach people is, we all will have our contact directly. No one's going to do anything or what have you. Our space people are going to contact us. And when they do, when you have that contact that's facilitated, you'll have that experience. So what's going to be happening now is that people all over the world, there'll be one initiated person by the star people that will be contacted, whether it be in Russia or whether it be in the Himalayan mountains or Tibet or whatever, there's going to be these groupings that are people that will be chosen by the Ashtar Command all over the planet, the star people, so to speak. When that happens, and that will start happening like a domino effect, there are going to be a lot of people that will be going together on these spaceships to bring information back to their own parts of the Earth that will help people on the planet. With that said, it's now almost about 1:22 in the evening, in the morning. Obviously, we're not at 100,000. I don't think we're going to get there. We're at 53,000 likes here tonight. But we've had 4,800 people watch our show. So since I got on here about 11:42 till about 1:23, we've had, and thankfully, we've had 4,800 viewers since 11:45. That's a lot of people. I want to be a contactee. That will come with contact with your star family. Once they contact you, you'll definitely be a contactee for sure. So, hey, Alcove, good to see you. We're going to sign off here for the night. I want to thank everybody for being here. We'll be on at 11 o'clock tomorrow night at our normal time. And we might be on tomorrow morning with our morning edition. Everybody take care. Have a good night. Thank you for the gifting. I think actually we need to finish the gifting. I've got only five more hats to go. Five more of those hats. We need to do five more hats here before I go to sleep and sign off the TV program, Encounters. Scotty Smokey, We'll have you on tomorrow night, or maybe tomorrow morning when we're on. We'll definitely have you on. Honey McReynolds, thank you. We've met 50% of my goal on gifting. Paranormal, thank you for the roses. We appreciate it, whatever gifting you want to do. I have 4 more hats available on the shelf. 4 more hats. We have 4 more hats. And I'm not an auctioneer person on encounters, but certainly thank you, Laurie, for the roses. We appreciate certainly the gifts. And everybody on here. Ah, Sansang, thank you for the cap. And almost there. We have 2 more caps to go. Chef Sean, thank you for the roses, Chef Sean. We appreciate you being a viewer and watching it. Linda, thank you. The eclipse was good here in New England. It was quite good, and then it got a little bit cloudy. We have 3 more hats to go, baseball hats. So I need to complete my goal before we sign out of here. Off the show Encounters, the number one late night spiritual talk show. So we're looking at 3 more hats. They're those black and purple hats, I think they are. Let me make sure I pin the goal here. Okay, I just pinned the goal. So if you see my goal pinned, I need 3 more hats. We'll see who's going to be the giver. All gifts are given unconditionally. There's no conditions here. So we'll see what happens. Okay. Well, it looks like we're not going to complete our goal tonight. That's okay. That's all right. That's exactly where we're at here. So I want to say good evening, good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow morning. If we're on here, we'll see you tomorrow morning. Chef Sean, thank you for a hat. You've been a blessing. Thank you so much. We only need 2 more hats. Hey, Hat Red Audie, good to see you. I'm just starting to look at comments here as I'm getting a little bit faded out here. So again, before I fade out completely, I want to thank you all for being here. And I actually need 2 more hats to go off the show. 2 more hats. Wherever those hats come from, I don't know. But, yeah. Yeah, 2 more hats. I have, Wolfman, thank you. Thank you, Laura Lee. Wolfman, thank you for the happy face. Yeah, take care, Angel. April, man, I'm getting so tired of misspelling names. I'm going to sign out of here before I end up being on here all night and you have me sleeping in front of the camera. Take care, everybody. We'll catch you later. We'll catch you tomorrow morning with another edition of Encounters.